Now we're back in the lounge with Jeannie D and Jeana Bell. And of course, she is a global award-winning author and business coach who is passionate about empowering women through purpose-led entrepreneurship. She hosts annual Women's Economic Empowerment Conferences in an aim to change the economic paradigm, I suppose, for women through business entrepreneurship. And in light of Women's Month, she is on tour in the country to speak about unlocking your unique personal and professional potential. If you have any questions for Jeana, please head over to our socials using the hashtag Afternoon Express. Hey, Jeana Bell.
Hello. Hello, Jeannie. How are you?
So wonderful to have you here.
Oh, thank you
so
much.
How's your trip been so far?
It has been absolutely phenomenal. Just wonderful. And I love Cape Town. Oh, yeah. My goodness, it's so beautiful here.
I'm such a huge believer that your thoughts become your actions.
Yes.
The way you speak about yourself to yourself in your head becomes, and that resonates with how you live your life. So what happened in your life to get to a point when you were like, I'm changing, I'm literally flipping my life upside down?
So this is a good life because I am in the midst of a whole rebirth.
Yeah.
And it happened as a result of, you know, I was the girl that checked all the boxes,
yeah,
right? Did everything right, right? And then all of a sudden, the marriage, the job after 30 years was gone. So everything that I had defined myself as was gone.
Yeah.
So I had to regroup. I had to find myself all over again.
Yeah.
And it was in the midst of that, in the midst of losing everything, the house, the job, the marriage, all of that, that I was there left with almost nothing. And it was that mindset that you talk about. It was that rebirth that said, you know what? I can't live like this. I can't stay like
yeah.
this. And I have a child I have to take care of.
Sure.
And it was in the midst of that that I found purpose. And it was, so the last 4 years of my life are much different. So
incredible.
Most people even think that, like the driver this morning, he's like, oh, you're like 36. I was like, oh, I love you. Because
yes.
that's the way I feel.
Exactly. So tell us a little bit about what happens at your conferences.
So at my conference, it is empowering the woman through economic
yeah.
means, because it's not just any conference. It's really a movement. And the movement is about helping women to understand their value, understand their purpose, and how they can change
yeah.
the trajectory of their economic paradigm. And when
yeah.
you look at that paradigm around the globe, it's limited.
Yeah.
And so it's not enough. We got to change it. And so at the conferences, women, international speakers who are coming in and they're training, and it's about how do you start your business, scale it, and become a sustainable business. So you change your communities, you change your family, you start building a legacy.
Yeah.
But you have to overcome fears and you have to step out of your comfort zone to do it. So it's about taking action.
Sure. This is one of the best messages that I think we could be spreading, I suppose, across South Africa at the moment. I read an article recently that women over 50 are starting careers, changing
yes.
careers, building businesses on their own. I mean, amazing.
Yes.
What a time to be alive.
Yes.
And often, I think, at an age where sometimes women think, oh, I'm irrelevant. And so what is that change that you can do to your mind to re-energize?
I'm so glad you asked me that. Because it's all about, so I wrote a book, and the
yeah.
book is called Mirror Affirmations. And it's about once you shed the past, once you divorce yourself from all the negative things that have happened in your life, you begin to see yourself as God has created you.
Yeah.
And when you can do that, you start seeing the power that's within. You start embracing the woman that you really are. And it's no longer accepting what society has said that life is over
yeah.
after 50. Mine really began after 50.
Yeah.
And it's about going and living the life that you deserve,
exactly.
not the life that society said we should be limited to.
So do you think that changed your life, doing your mirror affirmations? Does
Absolutely.
That work? What
Absolutely.
Is yours, if it's not too personal to share?
No, not at all. And I should say this, when I think about mirror affirmations, it's about making the mirror your best friend.
Yeah.
So when you look in that mirror, because I had a choice.
Yeah.
Do I see the woman who is now over 50, she's single, she's lost her job after 30 years, and it's time for a fresh start?
Yeah.
Or do I see the woman who got through it all?
Yeah.
And so when I look in the mirror, I see the strong woman who not only survived but thrives. Yeah. And now loves every bit of her, regardless of what the titles are, regardless yeah. of what the material possessions are.
Yeah.
It's about who she is, because that's who God has created her to be.
So just to share, I suppose, how to do it with our viewers, how do you do your mirror affirmations every morning?
Every morning.
Is it the same message every day?
It's different messages.
Okay.
But it's about what do you need that particular yeah. day to step into your power.
Yeah.
So today it is... And I'll just tell you what I did today.
Yeah.
And it was like, you know what? You got this. You can yeah. do this. Life is opening up. Life is yours. Just yeah. go get it.
Yeah.
Because that's what we have to do. We have to step into it and not wait any longer. So it's about understanding. So I wrote a post just today, and it was about who am I really?
Yeah.
And I'm the one that can look in your eyes
yeah.
and see all your possibilities. Your mm-hmm. eyes might be saying, it's not possible for mm-hmm. me. But what I see is, no, it's possible.
Yeah.
So I can look in people's eyes and just see that and see all that's possible for them.
Yeah.
And no matter what. And so I just tell myself every day, be the person that God has created you to
yeah.
be. Every single day.
And it really, really works. I do self-affirmations every single day, whether I do it through a meditation or through my mirror affirmations.
Mm-hmm.
And it is incredible. It really, really does work. Thank you so much for being here today.
Oh, thank you.
I cannot wait for your conference. I really hope you have the best time in South Africa.
Oh, thank you so much.
And I think all of the details on your conference will be on our website, Afternoon
yes.
Express. So we've asked you on our socials if you have any questions for Jena. And Tyler Rachgamani said, what inspired you?
Oh, what inspired
yeah.
me is that understanding that as a woman, that coming after the storms, that now I can inspire other women because of everything that I learned during that time when I was sitting there in that fetal position wondering what my life was going to be.
Mm.
And I saw that light. And it was at that point that I realized that I could change my life.
Yeah.
And so I became more inspired to help women all over the world because I had been down, I had fallen, but now it's rising.
Exactly.
And if I can just share that with women.
Yeah, and yeah. it's a global mission that you're
it's
on now to uplift
mission.
Women wherever you go, and you're certainly very good at that. Tando Dlamini asked and says, happy Women's Month, Jena. Worldwide women are taking a stand. We are a powerful influence in all sectors. And as great as women are becoming globally, what are still the challenges for women in becoming great entrepreneurs?
I think the biggest challenge that women face has to do with, number one, our confidence in who we are.
Yeah.
Because if whoever you are in your personal life, you will be in your business. So when you understand what your gift is, what you're selling, what you can do, how you can change lives, it then begins to change you. So I think number one, overcoming. Also, women are the fastest segment of new entrepreneurs across the globe, but we also have the highest level of discontinuation. So understanding how to get funding and understanding yeah. how to build really a scalable business mm-hmm. is the biggest challenge that we have.
And also, as a woman, as you get older, your life just gets better because
yes.
you think of yourself and you receive yourself and the things around you differently.
Yes.
Thank you so much for being here. You
oh,
are a huge inspiration.
Thank
we
you
love
so
you so much.
And I have to give you this.
Yes, what
so
does it mean?
It is the Purpose on the Rise inaugural launch band. So
amazing.
This is for you.
Oh, stunning. Purpose on the Rise.
Yeah.